exciting time in Bloom's Kitchen. Thank you so much for joining me. Today we are going to be making a Nigerian delicacy. We are going to be preparing yam porridge using the traditional method. For this, you can use any type of yam you have available, whether white, yellow, purple, or for those of you who only have potatoes, you're still good to go. Now, there are so many different ways of making this. So today I'm just showing you one style. And of course, feel free to adjust the ingredients to whatever you can find locally. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. And if you haven't subscribed, this would be a perfect time to click and also click on your notification button. That's where you see new videos I upload every single week. Sit back, relax. We're going to go over now and go through the ingredients very quickly. Thank you. Welcome back. So for our yam porridge today, I'm going to be using dry fish. I have this soaking in hot water because I just want to get it soft. And for my oil, traditionally you use just palm oil, but I like to use half and half for my palm oil and canola. So I'm going to be mixing those two. Salt to taste. Here I have some cayenne pepper. You can use blended as well. And here I have chicken stock powder, some scotch bonnet pepper, and this is medium heat, so it's not too hot. Feel free to adjust that also to your taste. And here I have crayfish, one large red onions, some ginger, and then I have one yam here already peeled. I have this sitting in cold water, that way it doesn't get brown. And then I have two bell pepper, green and yellow. Feel free to use any color of your choice. I usually prefer even red, but I have none right now. And then for my spice, I'm going to use this Spice City seasoning. It's mostly for stew, soup, and jollof. And then I'm also going to use this pepper and onion tomato seasoning mix. So if you don't have any of these, you can use your tin tomatoes or tomato paste, or even use regular tomatoes. And for your seasoning and some other food items, you can get it from Amazing Grace Foods. That's where I got this from. And then for my garnish today, I'm going to be using parsley and basil. Now, you can use any garnish of your choice. Some people like to use pumpkin leaves. So like I've said, always use whatever you have available and whatever your taste preference is. But do give this a try and then let me know what you think. And the basil is from my garden. If you haven't watched any of my garden series, after this video, you can do well to go check it out. So we're going to get started. We'll just start with the yam. I'll put half of the onion, and then I'm going to blend the remaining half onion, ginger, crayfish, and the pepper. And then we'll get this video going. Thank you, and don't forget to subscribe. It's already, our yam porridge is done. So this is really super quick, fast and easy. And if you want more sauce, just add more water. If you want less of the sauce, you can also add less water. For me, I like more sauce. That way, when you cut the yam, you can really have something to go with it. And also bear in mind that as it cools down, the sauce is going to get even thicker. So you don't want to make it too thick, or you can make it to whatever you like. So give this a try. Leave me a comment in the comment section. Let me know how do you enjoy your porridge. Until next time when I bring you another exciting recipe, have a blessed and wonderful day. Thank you.